What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
Thanks to Bricky Leaky over on Instagram, who's a new leaker on the scene, we have some information on the LEGO Marvel Studios collectible minifigure series too. Now, it should come as no surprise that we're getting a second series. The first one sold so well, and in fact, it's already hard to find in stores just a few months after it came out. It was overwhelmingly popular compared to previous minifigure series of all licenses, so I'm excited for a second series, but check out the new information we have. Now, just like last year, it's very likely coming out in the September or October months of the year. Just like the last one, fall makes a lot of sense for it. There's probably going to be 12 minifigures, because pretty much all CMF series have that at this point. And the biggest rumor is that it's not just based on the Disney Plus shows like last time. This could be reaching into other mediums for Marvel, which really at this point would only be the movies, but that's still really exciting to possibly check off some boxes of figures we didn't get the first time around. But the question now is, what could realistically be included? Now for the year 2022, we know for sure that we're getting Moon Knight, She-Hulk, Ms. Marvel, I Am Groot, and the Guardians of the Galaxy Holiday Special on Disney Plus. In fact, they'll probably come out in that exact order, which is really exciting. As for movies, I don't think that any of the 2022 Marvel movies will be included in this, because all of them are supposed to be getting sets, so it wouldn't make sense for them to take up spaces in the CMF. Now, we could also be getting What If Season 2, although this year does seem pretty stacked on Disney Plus, so I doubt that. For the same reasons, I kinda doubt Spider-Man Freshman Year, but since both shows are animated, it's certainly possible, and Secret Invasion has been talked about a lot, so it's possible that could squeak in by the end of the year, but I really, really doubt it. So with that being said, let's talk about the possible figures we could get, knowing what shows are coming out, and of course, knowing what movies have come out in the past. First figure I think we could get is actually Kate Bishop. Now, the Hawkeye series came out in 2021, but I think it's entirely possible to get Kate, being that she's a main character, a figure that people will definitely want, especially going forward with Young Avengers, and, you know, she was too late to come out for the first CMF, so I really think we would get her this time around, probably with a Lucky the Pizza Dog accessory dog piece. I also think we'll get Moon Knight, She-Hulk, and Ms. Marvel, being that they're the main characters of all their own shows that are coming out this year. And I also think some variation of a holiday Star-Lord would be a lot of fun. That is, assuming that we get, like, a holiday Star-Lord costume in the holiday special, but I don't think that we're gonna get an I Am Groot figure, because I Am Groot is based on Baby Groot, and we did get a Lego Baby Groot, but he's too small to be his own CMF, so maybe he could come with Rocket or something, like you get two for one, but anyways, I think Star-Lord is just a little more likely than that. Unfortunately, there are going to be some figures that are a little less likely. In my opinion, that's Ronin and possibly Daredevil. Let me explain. I think Ronin is just a little too violent for, you know, the kids, and I guess to some extent so is Daredevil, but Ronin played a very big part in the Hawkeye series, and of course, I did say that Hawkeye came out too late for CMF Series 1, so if they were ever going to get figures, CMF Series 2 is the time to do it. And for that reason, I could see us getting a Ronin version of Hawkeye. We've all wanted it since Endgame, and now would be the perfect, perfect, perfect time to make that happen. Similarly, I don't see the MCU Daredevil getting his own set anytime soon, but it is rumored that not only Matt Murdock, but also Daredevil is going to show up in She-Hulk. Now, what's here, you know, you see the classic Netflix suit, would not be the Lego figure. According to the rumors and leaks, if you don't want to hear this, just skip ahead, but according to the rumors and leaks, Daredevil's suit is actually going to be based more on his yellow suit. So it'll be like the style you see here, but with more yellow based on his first appearance. So if we get Daredevil, I'm guessing it would be based off of that, since that's what he'll likely look like in She-Hulk. But yeah, it's possible we could get this one, but, you know, he and Ronin are just so darn violent in their respective shows that I think it's a little less likely we would get them in their CMF form. And coming up on the very unlikely figures, these are the figures that I feel like are glaring omissions in the LEGO Marvel MCU lineup that we haven't gotten yet, and this would be a perfect opportunity to do so. The first of which is the homemade Spider-Man suit from both Civil War and Spider-Man Homecoming, as well as Spider-Man Freshman Year. That's an animated series that's going to take place between the events of Civil War and Homecoming. So actually, I think it takes place before Civil War, now that I say it out loud. Anyways, it's kind of Spider-Man's origin story, so we'll probably see him swinging around in this suit for most of it. So it's going to be topical and relevant again, and this would be a great time to get that suit. Speaking of great times to get suits, the Captain America stealth suit is one that we've not gotten yet, and this would be an awesome time to do so. Especially as the MCU moves away from Steve Rogers' stories, it just becomes less and less likely as time goes by that we would ever get this figure. So if this series will indeed reach back to past Marvel, you know, movies and things like that, this would be a great time to include him. For similar reasons, we have not gotten an Odin yet from Asgard, which would be awesome to get, as well as Whiplash from Iron Man 2. I know Iron Man 2 isn't everybody's favorite movie, but he is one of the main villains of the MCU. You know, he's the main villain of a big Marvel movie, so it would be awesome to finally get him as a minifigure. And last but not least to round out my 12 is Stan Lee. I feel like Stan Lee could come out in 2022, being that it's the 10th anniversary of LEGO Marvel in 2012, and technically the 20th anniversary since LEGO Spider-Man debuted in 2002. It would be a perfect year to get Stan Lee with all those anniversaries stacked up, and putting him in a CMF series would be great. That way he's not gatekept behind a giant set, you know, like a $200 set or something that not everybody could get. Stan Lee is responsible for so much of our happiness, and the whole reason that we're here right now talking about LEGO Marvel, being that he created and co-created so many Marvel characters and stories, that I think putting him in a very accessible way for most fans to get would be very fitting. I think it's what Stan would have wanted, and it's certainly what I want. And one other cool thing, too, is if Stan was included in a CMF series, he would be easy to get multiples of, so you could use the Stan figures for customs to make all of his cameos from across the MCU. Now tell me that doesn't sound awesome. Speaking of things that sound awesome, here's a little recap, guys. The Marvel Studios CMF Series 2 is not yet confirmed, but is very, very likely. It's likely coming out in September or October of 2022, with 12 minifigures total in the series, just like last time. And the rumor is that it's not just based on the Disney Plus Marvel shows like the first time around, it's gonna reach back to some older MCU movies and fill in some gaps. So with that being said, drop a comment below and let me know what you think of these rumors and my speculation. Do you think I'm right on the money? Do you think I'm in left field? Do you think I'm crazy and this isn't gonna happen at all? Drop a comment below and let me know, but most importantly, don't forget to hit thumbs up and subscribe down below, because I'll keep you updated on this and all of the other LEGO Marvel news as it comes out. Thanks so much, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for checking out today's video. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to hit like and subscribe down below. And while you're here, maybe check out one of my other videos.